work on tripping. Hey, folks, it's me, the Object Guru Cachet. What is up, coffee? Have a good day? I certainly hope so. Alright, now, we're going to start off with the game. It's just a demo, don't worry. I'm very excited about it for reasons that are going to become apparent, I think, pretty quickly. At least I hope pretty quickly. Okay.
Bonjour tout le monde!
Alpha demo, phase A, blah 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 blah. Hopefully this isn't too blaringly loud. That's fine. So, what we have here is a game called Monster Mappa. And what you might notice about the game Monster Mappa is that it is... Oh, let me quickly check something. Is that it is a 100% shameless ripoff of my favorite job game of all time, Viscera Cleanup Detail. I know, we're going to have to get that Nicolas Cage. Alright. So, Viscera Cleanup Detail is famously the best game. It spawned an entire genre of now super popular cleaning games, which is great. No one's questioning that. I mean, seriously, look at the mop and tell me, like, was this just built illegally on the engine of? Anyway, the point is. But see, the difference between my beloved, what the hell is that? You know, I'm sure they'll teach me as we go. It's shocking.
Shocking, I say.
How
shocking.
In no way. They're not even pretending that this isn't just a complete ripoff of my beloved Viscera Cleanup Detail. And Viscera Cleanup Detail, it really just created this entire genre of cleaning games that are now taking.
Did you
fix the
volume?
Did I?
They can barely hear you.
All right.
Sorry, everyone. He's fixing.
As I was saying, the Viscera Cleanup Detail created the entire genre of cleaning games. Which are now just doing gangbusters numbers, crazy amounts of money. All because, and this is the key part, there's no nice way to say this. I love the game, but Viscera Cleanup Detail seems to hate you for trying to play it. And all of the other games added quality of life stuff and are constantly like, it is a game of cleaning up messes, and there is a 30% chance anytime you spawn a bucket to clean up stuff, the bucket dispenser will just spew blood and viscera all around the room. Yeah. It's a game that hates you. Like, it's actually actively angry at you for trying to play the game. Now, you take that out, and you have pressure washing. You have car detailing simulator. You have pool cleaning simulator. You have any of the renovation games that are so popular. And, like, the good people at, at my beloved, now how do I turn this? Okay, well that's not clear. The good people over at Viscera Cleanup Detail created this whole genre all by themselves, but they haven't benefited from it because they've just been sitting there for the past 8 years not making a sequel. When that's all we want. Like, I think the last new level, which was a Blofeld volcano base, like in You Only Live Twice, was like 5-6 years ago. I don't know if it's co-op. It's not out yet. You gotta remember, this is not Viscera Cleanup Detail. This is a rip-off of Viscera Cleanup Detail. Alright, there's a ragamuffin loose and his found its way to an old folks home. He's been invited out of town. Their absence. A door bite has thoroughly decorated the Gothic bar from Cooper Team. Okay. Maybe the full game will be co-op again. I don't know. It's not out yet. This is just a demo where they're saying, here's our proof of concept. We're shamelessly ripping off the best game. Alright. and we're doing it family friendly, whereas fundamentally the last game was not family friendly. And I love Visser Cleanup Detail, and I would love a sequel that's just as gruesome and bloody as that one was. Not a family friendly game. You okay? Go, girl. And once your mop gets too dirty, you have to wash it off or you're just spreading gunk everywhere. Okay. So then you switch over to hands. There should be a way to move. Yeah, they should have a button that, like, resets this to its optimum position, and then you can put it back on the wall. And the fact that, I mean, this game's in early access, it's just a demo, there's plenty of time for them to fix this stuff, but, yeah, there should be a correct orientation button to help you put these items back in the proper place. So the premise of this is magic monsters escape, and you have to clean up after them so that no one will know monsters are real. It's cute.
Love it.
As well you should. The game is very light on the ground vis-a-vis telling you how to play it. Why, it's almost like they're assuming that this game will be played by people who have already played this or Cleanup Detail and are desperately waiting for someone to rip it off so that they can just play more this or Cleanup Detail. How do I get more water? What is this thing? Ew. This one's supposed to bring the bucket with me? Ah, okay. See, that wasn't clear. And what about this? The answer is no. Test something. Also didn't work. Anything about Visser Cleanup Detail is that, what? Let's see. Where's my orient this properly button? We just lost all the water because there's no orient this properly button. Or maybe there is and the game just didn't tell me about it. That is possible. You can, like, put shell casings inside of a bucket to help move them around. It's actually a very nice system. Point is, Visser Cleanup Detail is an amazing game. Some might say too good. I might say too good. And I'm just happy that someone understands its quality enough to want to go out there and shamelessly steal its design and every element of the game. I just wish, you know, there had been 50 games like this rather than just the one so far. Also, this game has a mechanic where you're supposed to capture the monsters that have fled. Oh, there's the fireplace. Where is he? The music suggests that there's a monster around here somewhere. So, by far the biggest problem with Earth Defense Force. Oh my god, this or Cleanup Detail. I have not played Security Breach. I was boycotting any new products based on Five Nights at Freddy's because the guy is such a scumbag. But I assume it'll show up at some point. He never gets tired. Maybe I can hit him with this? Or maybe not. Oh, finally! Okay, he is desperately, monstrously adorable.
What the hell is that thing?
It's way too cute. Oh, it's R for reset rotation. Okay. Thank you.
Did the game tell you?
Yes, finally.
Yay!
So, theoretically... Wait, I can't, like, put it back in my inventory? That's weird. There it is. Thank you. Oh, that took too long. But we got there eventually, and that's all that counts. But yes, there's DLC for Security Breach just in time for the movie. Very smart marketing on their part. Like, I'm opposed to the guy, but, you know, I assume he's not the only person working on Security Breach. Not gonna get too heavy on you, but if you... You know all those laws about banning abortion and endangering the lives of women across America? If you paid for a Five Nights at Freddy product, you helped pay for that, so good for you.
Proud to say I didn't pay.
Oh, yeah, no, absolutely. Okay, nice. So, one of the big issues with my beloved Visser cleanup detail Wait, Paw Patrol movie and the new Saw movie are coming out on the same day? Wow. That's so much better than Barbie and Oppenheimer.
Actually want to see Barbie and Oppenheimer.
Yeah, but Saw Patrol is a better thing to say.
Yeah.
Careful. Oh my god. But yes, one of the big issues with my beloved Visser cleanup detail is that the game utterly failed to explain to you how to play the game. Now, this is just a demo, so that's not an issue we're necessarily saying here. But because they did not tell you how well you were doing at cleaning up the level, you would get through the level, you'd be like, yep, I cleaned up everything. And then you would ask for your assessment and leave and be like, oh, you failed. You cleaned up nothing. And you'll be like, what are you talking about? And then it's like, oh, no, there was one speck of dirt that you couldn't see in each room. And that's how bad it's going to be.
Are you playing any Nintendo games?
No, it's all yours. Go.
Yes!
Well, that's bad. Okay.
I have achieved supper, everyone.
I believe you.
And it is wonderful. Oh, alright, but I missed the comment.
What is this? And this? Oh.
Ouch.
Can I refill the bucket there? That would be handy. That didn't work. Dear games, I've said this before, I'm going to continue saying, put a line on screen telling me where I'm going to throw something if I press the throw button. It shouldn't be impossible to judge where something's going to land if I throw it. I always say that the thing that is much harder to do in real life than it is in video games is jump. Like, no human can jump more than a foot off the ground. And every video game character can. And the thing that is way easier in real life is throwing things, which any human being can do quite casually, and no video game character in a first-person context can shoot at all, can throw things accurately at all. Like, any random person will have no trouble.
Wow.
You'd have to be very uncoordinated. And those people are out there, the very uncoordinated. No judgment. Wait, someone shipped the monster here? That's weird. Let's see if I can refill the bucket upstairs, shall we? Yay, I knew it. Apparently I can't, use the sink. The question is, when I complete areas of this, will I upgrade my tools to work faster, take longer to fill up, or do things like that? Because a lack of upgraded tools or anything like that was a big problem in my beloved Visser cleanup detail, which honestly, I love it. Feels like, a Quake mod. You literally have to manually load levels from a list of levels. It feels like a mod more than an actual game. They never got the bells and whistles right. And again, the fact that the game actively hates you for trying to play it were the reasons I believe it never caught on.
You're so cute.
I just speak the truth when it comes to video games. It's all I know how to do. What up, Queen? I hope you feel better soon.
Hi, Queen! How are you feeling?
Careful. This is going great, by the way.
I even knew your driver's test this year, Poppy. That's awesome.
That's fantastic. Congrats. I hope you enjoy it.
Is the test very hard where you are?
Okay, perfect. Well, we're just talking about how Visser Cleanup Detail should have made all of the money because it's such a wonderful game, but the developers, by never making it user-friendly or marketing it correctly, left all that money on the table, and now an entire genre has popped up to rip it off, and this one is being more direct than most in how it rips it off. Oh, would you have it at your Japanese restaurant? There.
Oh. You showed it. That sucks, Queen.
Something terrible has happened?
Did you show Queen's comment?
Check what?
Did you show it?
What comment? I didn't know it was restricted.
Well,
see,
okay.
It's not showing it at all.
Well, here's the weird thing. So I'm trying to get Queen's comment. Queen says she's feeling like shit.
Okay.
Or shite for the Irish people. I clicked on show, and it's like another moderator has handled this.
Okay, well, I didn't, so there you go.
Do you have another moderator?
I don't know, maybe. Yeah. Visser Cleanup Detail created a genre and then did not benefit from it at all. Yes, Power Washing Sim is one of the many popular games that rips off Viscera cleaning detail.
I'm going to guess he has played it because he plays all of these games. It's weird.
Square was kind enough to send me a copy of that one. It was very weird. Square almost never sends me games, but they sent me Power Washing Simulator, and then this year, Forsaken and Dragon Quest Treasures, which, by the way, is unbelievably good. I cannot believe how good Dragon Quest Treasures is.
Oh, was that the one from the other day, the Super Adorbs one?
Yeah. Desperately Adorbs game. It's two Adorbs for its own good. Yes. Power Washing Simulator, all of the renovation games, they're all swimming in water that was designed, that was poured by the brilliant people who made Viscera Cleanup Detail. There was kind of a genius to Viscera Cleanup Detail, which was that it was made with a modular engine, and so they're going to be able to, like, get game levels from theoretically any game made with that engine. And just, like, turn that into a level of Viscera Cleanup Detail by just dropping corpse parts everywhere and let you, like, clean up after the events of a video game. But unfortunately, the engine they used was the one that, like, was used just for Shadow Warrior. So there was only ever a Shadow Warrior level. Hopefully, when and if they finally make Part 2, it will be made with Unreal Engine. So we can live the dream of having all sorts of tie-in games for Viscera Cleanup Detail. No, seriously? They had Tomb Raider? Wait, you're saying they had Final Fantasy and Tomb Raider themed levels for Power Wash Simulator? So Power Wash Simulator just didn't rip off... If that's the case, that means they didn't just rip it off a little. They ripped off every part of Viscera Cleanup Detail, shamelessly. I mean, respect... If the Viscera Cleanup people aren't going to profit from it, why shouldn't they? But it just makes me upset that Viscera Cleanup Detail never got the credit it deserves. I will go check that out in a minute. Dear developers of this game, if you happen to see me play it, don't think that I'm insulting your game just by referring to it over and over again as a shameless ripoff of Viscera Cleanup Detail. There's nothing I respect more than shameless ripoffs. If you remember to not make it so that the game hates its player, like Viscera Cleanup Detail, and actually like have sorts of all sorts of player facing improvements. You okay?
Yep.
What happened, woman?
Uh-oh.
You know, like a skill tree, like a way to speed all of this up. Tools so you can get rid of all the feces way more easily, stuff like that. Make it easier to catch the monsters as you level up. Like, just if you have a perk system, that's going to massively improve your game. It's what, the lack of that is why, again, despite being a massively wonderful experience, my beloved Viscera Cleanup Detail never caught on, because again, it hates people for trying to play. So like, put in a button that highlights all of the remaining dirt on a level. Put in a little marker that tells you what percentage of the dirt for this room you've found. Things like that. Make it, again, every post Viscera Cleanup Detail game has developed this giant suite of player-friendly options. So just go and shamelessly steal all of them the way they stole their basic game design from Viscera Cleanup Detail. It's as simple as that.
And by that he means be inspired by.
Sure, that's definitely one way to say it. This is an alpha, so it's not strange that there are bugs about what you can and can't clean. I haven't played Shadow Warrior Rebooted. Like I said, last one I played was Shadow Warrior 2 or 3, whichever one was on the PS4. I've not played the most recent one. Careful. Almost finished this place off. Uh-oh. Yeah, so the idea is you get these water orbs and you can use them to fill tubs with magic water to speed up your cleaning, which is great, but there's a water orb here and it's not like telling me how to use it. It's very weird. I can throw it, I can drop it. That's all I can do. No interact button. If I brought it over to the sink, it just doesn't work. It doesn't even fit in the sink. See? I'm supposed to put it in the pot, am I? The pot has a flat top. It looks like it has a convex part, but it doesn't. That's just a visual. It's actually just a flat plane on the top, which is fine. That's correct, Snake. He's supposed to be the Hong Kong Duke Nukem. It's a very weird franchise. Alright, is that enough? Yeah, I can still clean more. Hopefully they don't want me to do something crazy like reshelve these books, right? Although, honestly, if they did, that would be a cute little minigame thing if they did it sanely, like so. For example, see, this is a green book, and there were only green books on the shelves, and they automatically snapped back in to the, like, the book of green, shelf of green books. And so let's say I pick this one up, and there would be a little marker that that's where it goes, and I walked up and I did that, it would automatically snap into place. That would be a very fun minigame to add to this little objective. So apparently what happens is I'm getting too close to the... See, if I get any closer, I can't clean, but if I stay far away, I can. Sometimes. Again, the game's still... it's just a demo now. It's not even an early access. They have plenty of times to... Plenty of time to fix all of this. And now I gotta go refill this. At least it's not as easy to kick over the bucket accidentally in this game. And so, how can I tell how well I'm doing? Nothing about that in the game yet? Okay. Okay, rotate, drop, clean, nope. Always accidentally putting more bile everywhere. I didn't know DC Universe Online still existed. Good for
Hello,
them.
Jester, I'm playing Animal Crossing. I bought the DLC. May never leave the house again.
Crossing, you are a delight. Okay. Keep turning. Okay, it won't keep turning, that's weird. I'm all facing the wrong way. Very strange. That's adorable. And again, the entire thing that they were supposed to be doing with this or cleanup detail, which is using levels that already exist to quickly make content for another game. Yeah, so they're just ripping off every part of that game. Which, again, respect. If the Visser cleanup detail people aren't going to do it, somebody has to. It was a great idea. Alright. Adorable, Jester. What is its supervillain name? Alright. I do. I brought the Adorabite back home. Now, what can I spend this money on? That's the key part. I got 437 space bucks. What are they for? Exactly. A cutie. Aww, they're called ragamuffins. Alright. Explore the house for ways to spend your hard-earned coins. I do want to unlock door. Oof. Choose a gadget, spell monster, more operation, which was in the game. Okay. I badly want to play more of this game, so please send me in development versions. I will play work in progress. I will happily cover the hell out of Monster Mop-Up if you want someone to. Because this thing is absolutely my jam, as I've talked a ton about. Alright, the next game might be a little too cute. I'm warning all of you in advance that the next game might be a little too cute, so prepare yourselves. This game is called Super Cat Boy. Yes, the DLC.
Happening.
We're on a space, sorry, an airship.
Run by dogs?
Yep.
Rob?
We kidnapped a kitten. See? Oh no! Oh, the dog's freaking out! They're about to crash. We did play Stray, Benson. We played through the whole game on stream. Like, you go back to, what, November, December, something like that?
Something like that.
You can actually watch 5 streams of us playing the entire game from beginning to end. It was delightful. Yeah, we loved Stray.
Yes, we were big fans of Stray. Yes, I'm playing Animal Crossing. I finally caved and got Animal Crossing.
Oh my god, you start the game with 9 lives.
At the end of April. It is fantastic. I'm highly enjoying it. I have a giant house.
Adorable.
And I just got the Happy Home DLC. I had resisted getting it for so long because I was worried I would have an unhealthy addiction to it during shutdowns. And I do. So, nice to know.
Can I have
right.
Some more health, please? No, I found 1/4 of a happy kitten statue. Oh my god. There's my health. Oh no! Yes. A Star Labs creation. It's a very cool concept. Lupus.
Aww.
Yes.
I hadn't heard that. I'm not a big enough Disney fan to be interested by it. Like, don't get me wrong. I like Disney stuff. I'm not an idiot, but, you know. I'm not a huge Disney fan, so. And I'm really enjoying Animal Crossing.
Better get more Animal Crossing. Oh, like that.
I had also heard it wasn't as good as actual Animal Crossing.
How could it be? No!
So, you know.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Triangle jump! I mistakenly thought I could jump over that guy's head.
Oops.
Oh my god! Alright, you're ready to see something too cute? Watch him when he ducks.
Aww.
Cat with a gun! Watch out for cats with guns, that's all I'm saying.
Well, Well, I mean, we already know cats with opposable thumbs will just set fires all the time.
Oh, my God, will they ever.
This is a reference to a not well-known sci-fi fantasy series.
Boom! Crushed it. Got 3/4 of the kitten statue.
And yet, I insist on referencing it all
the
time. The
fact that she fired a shotgun and blasted all those guys made me super happy.
Oh my God, the flowers are taking over. My plan has come to fruition.
Whoa.
So I've decided to take over, like, anywhere you want to walk. And you have to walk through flowers.
Well, that was awesome.
Ooh, what the hell is that? And, yeah, it's going well. I also have so many different crops now. So exciting.
Ooh, that was close.
And all the crops.
You're cropping it up?
Oh.
Did I get all the cat parts? Oh, and it's a cat part!
Oh, it's a catastrophe!
Ugh.
Sorry, that's awful clawful of me.
You're the worst.
Yeet!
See? Told you.
New flowers!
Oh, you can pick whatever level you want.
That's fun.
Alright, you got some advice for me, lady?
Aww.
Boom. It is a very super contra vibe, yeah.
Oops. Yeah.
You can jump on their heads. And they do a cute little squish animation. Oh, I didn't keep the bullets I used.
Gotta go visit my island bestie.
Nice.
Aww. That's right, y'all. It's Animal Crossing. I have a bestie on this island.
As well you should. Hey, what's up, puppet?
Bonjour, puppet. Comment ça va?
Got it. Dog part number one. Cat part number one. Oh my God, look at him climbing. Oh my God, how are you so cute? Oh, you've got a ninja kick there. Ow. There we go. Which one is unraveled? That was embarrassing. Wait, you lose a life? You don't just lose health for falling down a pit? Oh, nuts to you, game. Whew. Yes. Alright. That felt scary. Oh, this is Santa's workshop mission in Pity 2. Nice. It is the same genre as Cuphead, but that Cuphead was all boss rush. And this, I mean, there were a couple of non-boss rush levels, but you know. Did I just get catnip? No, I did not. So I was supposed to dash. The game didn't tell me how to dash. Alright, zipline! Oh my God, he's so happy to be ziplining! That's so cute! I officially love this cat. Yay, you can do a dash punch! Can I do a dash slide kick? I cannot. Oh my God, it's a pitfall style rope. Boom. Of course we missed you, puppet. Where you been? Whoa, that was weird. I got the full kitten! Did I get an extra life? You're damn right I did.
You gotta be kidding me!
Boom.
I'm sorry. Are you getting tired of the puns? Would you like me to pause them?
Oh my God. Oh, we're bouncing to her crib, Furball. This is cute. What is up, Fire Gaming? Oh, Fire Gaming VR. Fire Gaming is pro VR. As well you should be. VR is the best way to play video
games.
Yes.
A certain someone here loves them. It's not me.
I've been playing a little, some might say, too much Until You Fall, which is literally the best video game ever made. That's an exaggeration, but how much of one? I've got unlimited bullets. Okay, that was awesome. Very renegade. Kind of hard to tell where in the screen those are exactly, and what part of you is supposed to touch them. Ow! Okay, that was cool. This is called Super Cat Boy, and as you can see, it's a delight.
You're now on bikes.
I know.
Crazy.
Played anything good in the realm of VR lately? Fire Gaming Ver. Cat part number two.
Aw, well, we're happy to
it
have you here,
Steam.
Puppet.
Steam or only, in fact. I have Into the Radius. I should load it up. I played it when it was very early in early access, like the first day it came out or the first week it came out. It was very roof. But that was like 2 years ago. Also, I have a better computer now, so you put those two things together, I'm sure it's a much better experience. It's one of the many, 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 many video games based on the novel and movie Stalker. People just love making games about Stalker. Stalker, Metro, and you're like, well, Metro's based on its own thing. Yeah, it was heavily inspired by Stalker. Don't try to tell me it wasn't. Oh, did I miss one? I missed one. I didn't even know where I would have. Oh, no, I did get all four. Well, now I'm confused. No, we haven't watched the new Scooby-Doo show. We watched it in
The Velma one?
Oh, yeah, I just got Bone Lab. I should load it up. No, the most recent one.
Oh.
What's new? What's going on? Whatever it's called.
Oh, I watched some of it.
Yeah, you told me the art style was abhorrent.
Yeah. I was not a fan of the art.
Yeah.
Which is a weird thing to say when talking about Scooby-Doo. And I acknowledge that.
But we watched the end of 13 Ghosts. That was delightful.
Yes. Oh, my God.
But there will never again be something as good as Mystery Incorporated, I'm sad to say.
And then I just started watching Mystery Incorporated again.
Yeah. It's too good for its own good.
Okay.
Okay, I will keep that in mind. Are there good Bone Lab mods? Ooh. Tell me more. Nice. Mystery Incorporated's the best. I hope you're enjoying it. Oh, look, there's all our guns. Oh no.
Oh my God, is it your first watch through a puppet? Because seriously, it is my favorite Scooby-Doo show. So much fun.
It's desperation to be Alan Moore is the best thing ever. They're like, what if we do the Alan Moore Scooby-Doo? And the answer is, it would be perfect. It would be the best thing ever. They literally do League of Extraordinary Gentlemen with Scooby-Doo.
Yeah. It's just so good.
Gotcha. Are there any particularly... Aw. God, this game is so Metal Slug. Let's find out.
That was so good.
Aww. It's really cute. Also, he's dressed like Marty McFly.
Oh my God, he totes his.
Yep.
His run is adorable.
Yeah, this cat's amazing.
Well, excuse me. I am going to go change my wetsuit and go for a swim.
Nice.
The pirate guy, whose name is Gullivar.
Arr.
lost his communicator at sea, so I gotta go swim for it.
Oh my god!
Which means I gotta find where my
cat. He got bored and started licking himself because he's a cat.
Here's
that is weird. Try.
Huh. It was a poodle! How is this game so cute? Pomeranian! With that amazing smile locked on its face that Pomeranians have. God, this game's too cute. Yep, we're playing as the cat in the hot new video game, Super Cat Boy. But a cat who they were doing genetic experiments on for some reason, and then science happened. Okay. Yeah, I'll check down there for some stuff. Oh, it's bounce pad.
Seems to be missing a wetsuit.
No, what happened to it? I suspect it as much. You can go back down to the start of the level if you have any reason to, which you don't. Whoa! If that's where I'm supposed to go, then what's down here? Ah, just a bounce pad. I'm embarrassed now. Crash Bandicoot. I can see it. I mean, Crash Bandicoot was only ever, 3D. But it did it many levels of it involved some pretty intense platforming, so I see the connection. Oh, poor kittens. That was awesome.
Seriously, you stole a wetsuit. Oh, I got it!
Yay! I feel like you've been buying too many clothes if you're having as much trouble finding the wetsuit.
Yep.
Nice that I got no pushback on that. Brushed it.
There's my goggles.
I did not know. Like, I don't know why. Didn't expect this to go to a haunted mansion. Speaking of, when are we getting a new Splatterhouse game? Get off your A, Namco, and give us a new Splatterhouse game. We've been waiting 12 years for a new Splatterhouse game. Last one wasn't even that bad. It just wasn't great, you know? Oh, cool. Didn't even notice that. Ow. This game is so cute. Some might argue too cute. Dangerously cute. How retro is it? You have a score.
Oh, Jesus.
It's got 10 lives! Excuse me? Did I get them all? You're damn right I did. 100%! I will check out Unravel. What was the other game? Ooh, this might be a boss fight or something along those lines. I can say. Alright, let's do this. I saw you coming, Mr. Bat. I've played Splatterhouse. What is that? Yay! A secret lab? Tell me more. Oh, Into the Radius, yes. Well, I already have a copy of Into the Radius, so you don't need to worry about that. Like I said, they sent me a review copy when it was first going into Early Access. I do have a copy of Into the Radius. I will check out Unraveled, though. Oh, no! What the hell? Ow. Flamethrower! Why do I keep dropping it? Oh, you can't jump with the flamethrower. Okay, my bad.
God, that's adorable.
Yeah, with a flamethrower.
His ears are so cute.
They really are.
I just like watching him run because his ears go boingy, 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 boingy,
boingy,
boingy,
boingy.
Time for me to go swimming.
Oh my god, that was an unbelievably dangerous level. I need some health now.
Who's that?
Oh. Seems to raise some quest too, nice. Yep, cat with a flamethrower. It's what I call living the dream, everybody. You can climb straight up Mega Man style. Can Mega Man climb straight up? I honestly don't remember. I feel like he could. Mega Man X, I mean. Obviously, Mega Man couldn't climb at all. Spooky. Spydrons! Oh, you can't hurt them. You just have to avoid them. Smooth game. Very spooky level. What? This is my third piece of my first piece of treasure. My third gem. Yes, health. I found the health. Kitten. The flamethrower wasn't on the bed. The flamethrower was in the bathroom. I just brought it to the bed.
Wow.
Okay.
So bad. I'm like going for a swim. I'm going to empty all my inventory so I can collect a bunch of stuff to sell tomorrow or donate. It's going to be great. I wonder how long it's going to take me to find Gullibar's communicator right away.
Aww, cute. Go into the radius too, nice.
I will continue.
Presumably go further into the radius. So you can't hurt them at all. Well, less than that, eventually. Hey, Mr. B. Ow. These bats really are messing around. What the? Oh no. Spiked floor. That looks like it might be instant death. Certainly got that vibe. Nope, it wasn't, thank heavens. I screwed up really bad. You can do this. I couldn't. I was totally wrong about my ability level. But I got the health back. That's nice. That's from here. Nice. What'd you find?
I found a moon jellyfish. I don't know
what
it is. Nice. I'm 99% sure that's
I have not
you.
Pre-ordered the new Mario game. I just got Pikmin, so that's all I'm thinking about right now.
But we will be getting
The new Mario game.
Out?
When's the new game coming out? September?
I am very excited to play it.
Got it! And we don't have to go back the same way, which is nice.
Don't worry. We will be playing.
Yeah, it's
I
a new
might
Mario
be,
game.
You know, streaming.
Oh yeah, she will often stream games like that. Yes! Got a fit! Another cat part! That'll be the way back to the other one.
Okay. Catch you!
So they're extra men unrelated to the four pieces of Lucky Cat. Got it. Careful. Those look like traps, and I was right. Oh, look! The shell casings are getting caught! It's a little graphic glitch. Like, what are those things up there? The shell casings. Which are getting caught. So they're supposed to drop down like that.
What was that thing?
I missed a coin.
Horseshoe crab.
You watch out for those horseshoe crabs.
Getting
they're crabulous.
Stuff today. This is awesome.
Can't destroy these, apparently. Alright, here we go. Everybody's excited to find out how Mario Elephant plays.
Yes.
Were they excited as they were for a dinosaur Mario? No, but who could be?
Yeah.
It was a dinosaur
I'm
Mario.
I'm gonna be honest with you and say Dinosaur Mario was great. My favorite still remains Cat Mario.
Yeah, Cat Mario.
Although that
badass.
Is a great.
Oh
level
my God! Look at him. He's struggling to keep his balance
although,
like a cute.
The
kitty.
Weird thing is, like, it took you forever to play Odyssey.
I know. I was real busy.
I think it was during one of the shutdowns. It was the first shutdown that I was like, okay, you're just gonna play
exactly.
Odyssey. And I had never told him about the dragon.
Yeah, that dragon's baller.
And somehow it didn't get spoiled for him. So
well, I
like,
don't read news or
like,
watch other people's videos, so that does help me, you know. Did you hear about that upcoming video game? No. I don't read video game news. I wouldn't be surprised. The only video game news I read about is Supermassive Games, but that's because I run a channel devoted to Supermassive Games. I have no interest in any other video game news. If I, like, did a website, I'm like, oh my God, what is happening?
That is insane.
That was ridiculous.
Women run the island. Women around.
Yes, I do need that food. I never played Journey to Silius. What's it like? I have heard of it. I've just never played it. I had very few Nintendo games. Yes, I did rent a lot, but, you know. Wait, maybe Journey to Silius is the game I had. Is that the famous one where you fly around on a grid and warp places and have to land on planets? No, I'm thinking of something else. Oh, that's the one that they lost the Terminator license. So when I was a kid, I had this game for the regular Nintendo, where you flew from planet to planet, right? And you had to, like, boom, randomly land places to look for tech, and there were, like, enemy space stations and enemy spaceships. And the goal was to destroy all of the enemy spaceships and free up space. And for the life of me, I can't find out what this game was called. I've tried and I've tried and I've tried. What is happening? I got hit so much I got briefly knocked out. That's embarrassing. Okay. Got the cat, got my other extra life. Given how badly this has been going, I desperately needed it. Oh, come on! Dear game, I should be able to look down if you're going to pull that kind of nonsense. Okay, here we go.
It's like I've been trying to figure out. I don't think it's a Nintendo game. I think it was an Atari game?
What's this?
The one where you travel in space and you go through, like, gates to other parts of the galaxy.
Yeah,
and
maybe.
You're, like, fighting people. It's like such a fan of that game.
His ears perked up because I got health! You're damn right they did. We did it, everybody. We opened the door of the secret lab. Oh, I should have got a flamethrower. Oh, seriously? Nice. Do we have a Nintendo Online membership?
Yes.
Apparently I can play it. This Journey to Silius game. There's a lady cat.
You have to have Nintendo Online to go online.
Oh, right, and you're playing that online.
I had a need to travel to other islands.
No, I understand. So, this game is unbelievably baller. We are officially big fans of Super Cat Boy, and are looking forward to playing more. Next up, though, we have to play Draws, which, you'll see. It might be too cute.
You said that with the last game.
Yeah, and this one also is in that category. You have a good night, Snake.
Bonsoir, Snake.
No, girl. Alright, we're playing Draws. And you'll see why it's so cute in a sec. Ooh, concealed rewards. As you can see, we're playing as an ooze monster. Cruise Monster!
Lighthouse.
Now, if you want to talk about something that looks like, gotcha.
What the frick is that? Oh,
just gonna make sure I get all the stuff. You want to talk about stuff that looks like Crash Bandicoot? Look at this game's art style.
Oh, that looks a lot like that game.
Yeah, very similar art style.
Gameplay, too. Wow.
Oh,
the
yeah.
The way the things are whizzing back to the...
Yep.
Ooh. Aww.
Much more crisp than Crash. Crash Bandicoot. Wow, that was hard to say.
Really?
Yay! I found a scallop! Sorry. That brings Pascal the otter to me, and I am utterly just like... so obsessed with this otter. Here he comes.
I have.
It's happening.
Yes. I am, before my channel became entirely devoted to the Dark Pictures, it was most known for being a I Expect You to Die.
Yeah.
Like, it's the number one
he
place on the internet for
you,
guys
didn't
to...
Did you do a promotion for them?
I did an ad for them, yeah.
You did an ad for them, not for this game,
for
the last
one. For the second one. There will probably be another ad. You know, I can't say for sure they're going to hire me to do another ad, but it wouldn't shock me if they did.
He is a super fan.
I am as big a fan of I Expect You to Die as there has ever been. Okay, Lizette. Oh, you're here for the bounty. What bounty? I'm desperately excited about I Expect You to Die 3. And speaking of shell games, everyone needs to play Beat Saber. I haven't played. What I do play is I expect You to Die developer Shell Games' unbelievably good sword fighting game, Until You Fall. Same developers, it's perfect. If you haven't played Until You Fall, absolutely get yourself a copy of Until You
Is that
Fall.
The one you've been playing?
Yeah, it's perfect.
Yeah, it's insane.
It's so good.
I mean, I do have a slight bone to pick with that game.
Mm-hmm.
Certain someone gets so involved in that game. That
I sometimes punch people in the face.
No, you punched me in the shoulder.
Oh, the shoulder.
That's the bad shoulder. And partially managed to dislocate it.
Damn right.
It's fine, it dislocates all the time. But seriously.
It's the best game. Like, it is shockingly good. I mean, they only make great games over at to Shell Games, but this one is unusually good.
I wish I could play it, but alas, VR and I do not get along.
I don't have Blade and Sorcery. I should pick that up. I've heard nothing but good things about it. Okay, that's a note.
Which kind of sucks, because, like, I Expect You to Die was one of my favorite games in VR.
It's incredible.
I mean, it's no Tumblr.
Tumble VR.
Which, by the way, the irony when you told me that my favorite VR game was made by Supermassive Games.
Yep. The Flute of the Alchemist.
The Pearl. Oh, my God. Oh, can today be more perfect? Oh, this game likes to pun.
Hey, what's up with you, bird face? Yes, that is what I meant.
Aww.
It's a delightful song. Oh. Secret path through the sewer! Proto Mob, nice. And of course, the sewer is where the monster is about to end up. It's just a great song.
Oh,
no. Aww, it's so cute. Let's do it.
Oops.
Oh, it's one of those lure fish. Or goose fishing. Or angler fishing. Sorry.
Gotcha.
Woo! Ah! Oh, I scared him off. I didn't have to hurt him. That's great. Enchantment table. Is it the same sigils or very similar ones? I'm way back now. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, this is bad, everybody. Might have found the alchemist. This dude sucks. Ah! My precious arm! I need that!
Did he disarm you?
You're the worst. To find a shell. What? Aww. Yay. All right, now I'm a zombie, animated by a slug monster. Adorable. Oh my god, this is too adorable. That's why you need the coins. Hey, you can move again. What? Okay. That up there. Oh, there's 10 gems on the level. Should have known about that earlier. More careful. What the? That was embarrassing. It's my severed arm! Yay! I need that back in a minute. The draw's point. Oh, nice. How you doing, woman?
A little tired.
Aww.
Then I gotta go give Gullibah. I like saying his name differently
every
time. No! His caregiver.
As well you should.
I was right by the museum, so I decided to donate the new sea creatures I caught.
Right. Oh, I don't have to get it every time. That's embarrassing. It stays collected.
Yeah, right.
push things, your draws.
Hey, buddy.
What's this over here? Oh, we need a knight to help you. Health. I still can't jump, but you know. Awesome. Go, Senior Knight.
Be quick about it, or I'll buckle your swashes.
Ooh, a water raft piece. I don't know what that is. Excited to find out. That's famously true. We're real weirdos.
Who's a weirdo?
Humans.
Yeah. Why are we weirdos?
Just in general.
I thought there was a specific kind of reason.
No.
Some of us are weirder than others. Some of us appreciate weird.
It's weird that, like, using items, using areas like that, makes me drop out of. Okay, there was nothing over here. Well, there's that. Jump that far? Let's find that together, shall we? I can't believe that worked. Is that thing trying to drop something on me? It's not. Yes, very Crash Bandicoot with the item hunting.
Oh, hey, buddy. What's wrong?
Check. That's fine. He has to go in there to use it. I get it. Oh, I can walk.
Don't
drop.
Give me that side eye. You're
apparently
still right in front of the door.
Maybe I wasn't facing just the right way. Yes. All right, let's do it. It's a really good question. No? That makes sense. Okay. What the hell? Ah, we need the knight to pick up the giant. It's gotcha. Really good question that everyone was disturbed by, so bravo. I love when he leaves little splotches everywhere. Yeah. Let's do it!
Puppet, we're curious about your
photo. Hey, just three more. Aww. It is raining. It's not crazy to talk about the weather. Am I supposed to do something about that guy or what? This looked like the kind of place there would be a secret gem. It was wrong, but it really didn't look like it. trying, don't worry. We're streaming on Saturday next, Fire Gaming. But thanks for dropping by.
Bonsoir.
They're so cute together. No, I missed one. Oh well, case the rest around. Careful. Wait, I didn't have to do the whole run back. That's the whole point of the recall button. Anything else? The other gem is hiding. Not anywhere I can see. Oh well, face or SRA. Level wise, we crushed it. Wow, I got half of the possible glimmer juice. 9 out of 10. I screwed up the time, but I did get the piece of armor. That's true, I could. We're gonna go check it out. So yeah, draws, unbearably cute, like super ultra mega cute, very Crash Bandicoot by way of Maximo, with, you know, less elaborate combat, but I'm just saying the vibes. But from a platforming standpoint, this is a very Crash Bandicoot world. All right, so you're saying it's called Unravel? Okay.
Horking?
Unravel and Unravel 2. What is up, Horror King? So you play as a guy made of string. Oof. You don't have to install some EA nonsense to play it, do you? Yep, you do. Alright, well, I'll never buy it on Steam then.
What do you have to do?
Install the EA launcher.
Oh, right.
DRM.
And didn't it crash something when you installed
it? Yeah, it crashed when I tried to play one of the Battlefields. So I only play EA games on console. So I'll wait for it to be on sale on console. Oh, it's on Switch too? That's convenient.
Woo!
Oh, Resident Evil 4. I'm patiently waiting for you to come out on...
Something?
I'm patiently waiting for you to come out on PSVR 2. I'm going to first play Resident Evil 4 in VR, and I'm going to love it. Now we're going to check on a little something called Mr. Run and Jump. Hey, Horror King, what is up?
Bonjour, Horror King! Comment ça va? Wait, didn't I already say hello to Horror King?
You did. I said it twice, don't know why. Mr. Running.
Because we're both tired, because the heat is really awful.
The heat is a nightmare.
And then there's also the horrible air quality, because, you know, forest fires and
I did not see the live stream you did yesterday. What did you play?
My God. I got a mermaid dress.
Nice.
And it is my favorite thing in the whole wide world.
Awesome. No notes.
Oh my God. I'm so happy right now. Unfortunately.
So,
oh, no, wait.
I've played a bunch of this. It is delightful. I'm going to show off some more of it because... If you have any love for platformers at all, 2D platformers that is, I really think this is the game for you. Okay, that was down. is also down. You may just not be able to get those. Oh no, wait, I've got my dash, don't I? There it is. This might not help, but still. I have not played any Kirby games. I think ever?
Kirby?
Yeah,
no,
I know you have.
We have.
Played a little of them.
No, you played, we played one. The
on
Yarn
what?
One.
Which, oh, yes, I played a bunch of the Yarn one.
Yarn
one, yes.
Yeah, that one was great.
Yeah, that was amazing.
It was like a 3D one that got way too hard, way too fast, in a really strange way.
Yes. What? Whoa! This game does not mess around, and that's why I respect it so much. It just gets it when it comes to what we want out of sadistic platformers.
Ooh!
You okay?
Yeah. I was sitting in a bad position.
I understand completely. It could happen to the best of us.
Apparently I forgot to braid my hair.
No! Your hair needs to be braided for science.
Oh my god, I love this mermaid dress!
As well you should. Mermaid dresses are the cat's meow. That was close. Oof. That was embarrassing. Oh my god, this game. See, it's this, it's, yeah, is it kind of a sadistic platformer? Yeah, but it's so fair. There's so many checkpoints and levels. They got so many movement options. It's just a blast. Careful.
New things and sea creatures. So happy.
Okay. Marr. What is that? Oh, it's invulnerable. No thanks. They give you an invincibility star if you fail too many times. I just found out. That's an awesome Mario jive.
Love that.
He's the best.
What's the level in Mario where they give you the invincibility but it doesn't help at all? Because you have to like keep running on like paths.
Oh,
like,
they're crumbling underneath.
Yeah,
you.
And
yeah.
If you fall down, you die anyway, even if you're invincible.
Yep.
So giving you the invincibility doesn't help at all.
Oh, what level was that? Yeah. That was brutal.
It's one of the, like, what, 3D Worlds? The,
it might have been, like, 3D Worlds.
Yeah. Like, what was the first Mario we won? It's one of those.
Yeah, I think 3D Worlds. Or Galaxy 2, maybe.
Galaxy. It's one of the galaxies. It's either Galaxy 1 or 2. I can't remember which one.
Oof.
Bye.
Whoops.
Harvey.
All right, here we go.
Oh. Down to Dicko. Got a new mermaid dress on and everything.
Well, that took too long. Well, that took way too long, and I still love it. Okay. I didn't know that. Okay. Oh my god. This is so cute. I just missed a ton of stuff. When was I supposed to dive? just at the peak of my super jump? No, that's not it. I'm getting all these triangles. I don't care. Think less of me if you will. I encourage you to. I can still get that one. That made me too nervous. Hey, buddy, what's up? Ah, nice. I'll try it. Do this. That's a bonus air.
Dino.
They're fun to get to. Whoa, Mr. Toad. What? That almost worked. Okay, this is amazing.
Floyd hasn't switched out his freaking art yet.
Who are we talking about?
Oh, the shady art dealer. Everything he's selling today is fake.
Again?
Yep. Well, he hasn't switched it from the house.
Oh, I see. Right. Almost at him. That was bad. Oh no! Oh, I did not see that. Nice. An awesome power deck.
Horakin was asking if you saw the live stream from
and
yesterday.
I just said I didn't.
You did not. There you go.
Showing off a Yu-Gi-Oh deck.
Nice.
Yes. Apparently it's very good for... Ah! 1, 2, 3. Oh my god. That was amazing. No notes, me. You see, it's just an addictive game. Every time you fail, you're like, no, I could have done that a little better. It's got that, I'm not quite at fault quality that you appreciated from Super Meat Boy. I feel like, oh no, I knew I was responsible for that one, but I feel if I just do it a little better, that kind of thing. Okay, so it's jump, dive, jump. And here it's jump, dive, jump. What the hell? Okay, this is gonna suck. Oh my god, this game! What? Are you kidding me?
That's insane. Whoa, I can't believe you died. Yep.
This is the kind of nonsense they expect you to pull.
Yes, I wasn't paying attention. I was, you know, dealing with shady art dealers. Hippies in a commune. Okay, everybody else in the commune is great. There's this island that you visit. It's a
hippie commune?
Yeah, it's great.
Nice.
Love it. It's a one of my favorite things.
I understand completely.
Very tired, so I'm gonna have to change her out of her outfit and put her to bed because I'm gonna go to bed.
I can't believe that worked. Careful. How does it annoy your competition? Oh my god. Ah. Oh my god. Yes. I can't believe how well that went. What do you want me to do here? I see what I'm supposed to do. No! Alright, we got this. Tragically, no. And even I knew that. That Yu-Gi-Oh! Does not have Ash Ketchum. What? This is safer than I thought it was. Wow, two bonus areas on the same screen. This doesn't look safe. Time to bear with me. Ow.
This definitely needs to be wearing my red glasses. Super cute. Red circle socks. Oh, these are more cute red socks. Why are there red socks? I have purple.
What?
Yellow.
I didn't realize I had to do something when I got to the bottom.
Okay. She's just gonna braid her hair like me, and then she can go back. She's looking super adorable. And her...
No! So when I drop down, I have to immediately dive, right, jump, and dive again. Gotcha.
Scooby braids it is.
So it's jump down, dive right, jump, dive right again. Oh my god, this game! That almost worked. Please tell me this level's almost over. They are really enjoying torturing me. Which I respect, that is what they're here for. Okay, here we go. I'm making sure there's no coins down here. There weren't. Oh my god. That was insane. Nope. What do you want me to do here? There it is. Are you kidding? This game. What?
What? Whoa.
Oh my god, this level! Yeah, we heard. It's terrifying.
What's terrifying?
Got the Shattered Orb and the Challenge Orbs. Crushed it.
Oh yes, she told us. Well, she told me, and I told a certain pose. I'm really sorry, everyone.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
It's alright, it happens. I can't see, I'll check. Mic seems to be working, so that's good. Sorry, hot stuff.
I tripped over the cord and sent the mic
flying. Hey, Ashley, what's up? Oh no, it's a race level. I mean, I knew a boss was coming, but this is just brutal. I will. If you wondered, where am I no longer going to be getting all of the triangles? It's when there's a race level. See? Wait, there's... I don't have to do the whole thing over? Oh, I might get all of these then. Nope. Almost had that. We got this, baby. I know. No, I think Axeman is supposed to represent, Wait. What the hell? Hey, Pixel, what's up? Okay. What is happening? Yeah, as far as sadistic platformers go... See, that's the thing. I know maybe it's splitting hairs, but I never consider sadistic platformers to be rage games. I think the difference between a sadistic platformer and a rage game is in a sadistic platformer, you are given impossible challenges with, like, tight controls. But in a rage game, it doesn't really matter how difficult the challenge is, the controls deliberately suck. Like, Super Meat Boy, sadistic platform. Getting over it, rage game. I think to be a rage game, there has to be some limitation on the quality of the controls done purposefully by the developers. Oh, that's a really good level. Favorite.
Favorite what now?
I expect you to die level. What? Give me a second. I'm going to pause. Think about this. Getting over it is fun. Absolutely.
Like either,
it's a rage game.
Like, was it on a train or a plane?
It might be the train level.
Yeah, the train. Yeah.
Yeah, where the guy comes to the door, the guy spears you through the roof, you have to shoot down a plane. I just adore that. Plane level's amazing, though. Alright. That sucked. Come on. What is happening? Yeah, so this is Mr. Run and Jump. as you can see, it's really... First Class is the name of the level. Thank you. It's really banking it all on that neon vaporwave aesthetic that the kids are so fond of today. I'm kidding, of course. Kids are not fond of it. It's for retro nerds like myself who don't miss the 80s because the 80s sucked, but, you know, enjoyed much of the art and aesthetic of the 80s. My favorite Rage game is, I know nobody asked, but I'm going to share it with you because I want everybody to play it. It's something called That Flipping Mountain. Oh, I see what I'm doing. And I am not shy about my adoration to Left Flipping Mountains. It's technically a Rage game, but it has unusually accessible controls for a Rage game. And that may sound like it's cheating, believe me. When you see how the controls work, you will not say that. Okay, here we go. Still not entirely sure who Bennett Foddy is. Come on! I'm kind of doing this to myself, but you know. What are you gonna do? It's really hard to land this, because there's no, like, stomp. If there was a stomp, obviously I would have no trouble hitting that. There isn't, though. Now I'm just... Don't trip!
Thank you.
Now I'm just landing it and then immediately screwing up because I'm panicking and thinking I didn't land it. Ooh. That was weird. Come on. Nope. You got it? Yeah. Okay. Not a problem. Almost had it. Don't know why that didn't occur to me ages ago. Oh, you haven't played Little Hope? You should totally check it out. I mean, I have a mixed relationship with Little Hope, because even though I had been the only YouTube channel focusing on Super Games since The Inpatient, I only found any success with it starting with a Little Hope in a review where I excoriated the game. And you might say, well, why would you still be fond of a Little Hope? And the answer is, it does a couple of really interesting things. And more importantly, those videos excoriating a little Hope got me so many views that it paid for a PlayStation 5. So, Supermassive Games, in disappointing us all with a Little Hope, paid for my PlayStation 5. So thank you for that, Supermassive Games. I thank them for that a lot, actually. Careful. Nope. Almost had it. Whew. Great to see you. Hope to see you soon. Careful. Perfect. Yeah, that was messed up. Nice. Almost got it. Oh, nice! Happy almost birthday. Okay. Nope. That was awesome.
Happy birthday indeed.
Well, that's an interesting conversation. Why would you think it looks bad? Because I gotta say, when it comes to Little Hope, I'm a giant fan of this aesthetic. You see, are you a Silent Hill person? Because if you watch Little Hope, you'd be like, oh, so this is their tribute to Silent Hill. And I think that's the only way to describe Little Hope, as being a loving tribute to Silent Hill. Oh my god, how am I still alive? And it very much is. You okay, woman?
This is terrifying!
It is, right? Okay, drop. Nope. I would have beaten this a couple of times already were I not trying to get all of the triangles. I'm really making this much harder on myself. Super Meat Boy, of course, does not ask you to get things like triangles. There are occasionally band-aids you have to pick up, which is disgusting, but that's very much on the vibe of it.
Yes, you've heard me talk about Little Meat Boy and my non-appreciation for it.
Careful.
Oh, you are a fan of Silent Hill.
Yeah, so I'm not saying I can guarantee you like Little Hope, but... Yes. Well, the Axeman is in Devil. And I'm going to say it. I think the best monster design of the entire first season happens in Little Hope. And that's all I'll say about that. Keep screwing that up. Okay, I just noticed that this thing speeds up to keep up with me, which is not cool. It doesn't slow down when I slow down. Hey, VR, you're back. What is up? If you could let me get a little bit of a lead on this thing, guys. Oh my god, this level! I mean, it's exactly the kind of torture we're here for. Nope! That was close.
It was an invincibility star!
Yeah, but it can't protect you from that then.
Oh.
I'm not getting killed by, like, spikes.
Oh, so it's the equivalent of that burial level.
Yeah, of course.
Where?
Ah!
Yeah, it's one of the two galaxies. Where you keep dying, and it finally gives you a star. But you keep dying because you fall down.
Yeah, it doesn't help. Careful. Ugh! Okay, I don't know how I'm supposed to get those. I hate to say it, I may have to give up after coming this far.
I would have already given up.
I know. It's very much your vibe.
To be honest, as much as I see why you like the art style, I would have given up just seeing the art. It's very flashlight.
That is a weird order to have played them in, Ashley. You can actually turn the bloom up and down, which I think is a really nice thing for them to do.
Although I feel like if House of Ashes was the last one you played, like, everything's going to feel like a letdown after that.
House of Ashes is perfect, yes. Yes! That was the last room! Oh. Whew. Take that, Mr. Void. Looks like we had to destroy that void that was made up entirely of the concept of no. So you might refer to it as a noid. Forcing us to avoid a noid. Ow! It has that vibe, yeah. Alright, so I'm going to show off the... No, I'm not doing it. Actually, let's see what the time trial looks like.
Love your life. I'm not.
Well, if I don't have to worry about collecting everything, let's see if I can actually do this pretty quickly. Go for it, VR. Have you started playing it, and do you enjoy it? I've always said that Five Nights at Freddy's should have a, you know, actual Outlast-style game, so I was really happy when they announced Security Breach. I'm just gonna stop. This is humiliating myself. Oh, nice! Yeah, she's fun in Devil in May. All the Dark Pictures games are good in one way or another. House of Ashes is the best one by far, but they're all worth playing. Don't know why they asked Jesse Buckley to try to do an American accent in that game. No reason that character couldn't have been Irish, and her American accent is not great. There is no secret. I get that. Which game? This game? Mr. Run and Jump?
Apparently it's called Mr. Run and Jump.
Yes, they wanted to make it 100% clear what the game is about. You go, girl. Ooh. Yeah. Oh no! Okay, this level's gonna be real cute. I like the replacement for the skulls. The skulls might come back, but these are pretty cool. Oh my god. Because she says H.H. Holmes. She can't not say it that way. That's a tough one to get over, though. I get it. H. Instead of H.
Ah, yes. People saying that?
Yeah. Especially Irish people.
A lot of French people say it too, so it's something I grew up hearing constantly. You know that?
Yes, I do. Oh my god!
So, today...
You might be too good at this game.
I forgot the word for no-see-um. Like the bug.
Oh, yeah.
All I could think of... Well, it's weird, because back home they call them black flies, even though, you know, they're the same.
Yeah.
It's the same name for another fly, which is completely different.
Yep.
All I could think of was the French slang.
Weird.
Which is bit.
Crushing it. Yeah, no, people should not make fun of her for her accent. She's still working on it. She has time to get it right, but yeah. Her accent was fine in Fargo. Although it was a very weird regional accent, so you know. Maybe that's easier for her to do than just like a Chicago neutral accent.
Hell, I can't do a Chicago neutral accent.
Nope. Oh, I see what I'm supposed to do. Okay, so it's... screwed it up, but... What? Oh no! I suspected you were on the route to that when you told me that you got everybody else killed. Okay. Almost had it. Yeah, that's pretty cool. So one of the nice things about this game is, check out what you can do. I can go to the next screen and then come back and it'll save my progress. So I can just try it again. Oof, so evil. Come on, got it. Absolutely the wrong thing to do. But I understand why. Try this one more time and stop. So it's jump, dive, jump, dive, jump, dive, jump, dive, jump, dive, fall, dive. Okay. Whew. Are you kidding? Oh my god, this game! Bounce pads, I love those. Nice. That was embarrassing. And you saved Kate for all of few minutes. I do understand your instinct, though. Bunch of secret stuff down there. What? Are you kidding me? Nope, I don't see how to get that. I had a good run, but I honestly don't see how to get that. Oh, I think I know. So the idea is... Oh, damn it, I took the double jump. So you hop. So, you jump. Damn it. Slide. I can't believe I did that. So yeah, I'm Mr. Run and Jump. My wholehearted recommendation if you like sadistic platformer. Okay. Almost. That was dumb. Well, I've got to stop torturing myself here. It's hard though. Well, at least you got the trophy, even if you had to be a horrible person to get it. I don't understand what I'm supposed to do after I get that. So I get the coin, right? Well, that time I didn't, but watch. Get the coin. Did you not watch to the end of the credits? Because, spoiler alert, you didn't save Mark and Kate. Did you think Dumet was going to let them go? Yes, that's not saving. Quite the opposite, in fact. Careful. You okay, woman? I know, woman. You go, girl. Yeah, I just don't see how I'm supposed to get back up after I've gotten it. If there was a way to get a double jump back, that would be one thing. There isn't. Okay, well, there you go. I'm like, why aren't you swimming for it? Lake Michigan ain't that cold in October. In fact, in October, it's actually the warmest it is all year long. Or almost. Because it spent all summer soaking up rays. Yeah. I just don't see what I'm supposed to do.
Stop playing.
That is the only real solution.
But I say that to you every time you play one of these.
You do, yeah.
I feel like this is not helpful.
You know it, girl. Alright, I'm going to stop here for obvious reasons, reasons of sanity. They did have plenty of time, but he was pulling the thing back to him, so dropping down out of sight would not have helped, because, you know, he's got a gun. So, we'll see y'all back here soonsville, Saturday in fact. Should be a blast and a half. Send me a comment if there's anything else you need. Until then, I'll say that's right.